getting a lot of buzz in the chat about HCC. People who are longtime HCC coders, like, yay, finally some respect. And then a lot of new people are like, what is that?
Yeah, I have to tell you that our local chapter, when I mentioned it when I spoke at the local chapter, and of course, you know, it just like spills, I regurgitate HCC all the time, you know, because it's what I like to do. And so I'm always commenting on it. And I had several people come up to me afterwards and say, nobody talks about HCC, you know, and I'm an HCC coder and I love what I do. And so that was like three or four, and then then the next time that I spoke, they actually had other people that didn't get to come up and talk to me. So you HCC coders are really getting networked now, and it's growing. Not only in the past maybe you worked a lot of remote stuff, but facilities are hiring HCC coders, or they're doing their own departments, because it's all about Medicare, and they need to collect project. So if your facility takes Medicare, which you know they do, then they're going to end up probably having their own department. So it's a good area to be in. I mentioned before that our course, you know, a majority of what our course is about is the behind the scenes, why you do what you do, what are the MACs, what are the, you know, how are they audited, who's responsible for this and that, you know, which is the behind the scenes stuff that you aren't usually taught. And then in turn, show you how to abstract, also give you a lot of insight on the disease processes and treatments for the disease processes, because the more you know that, the more you know medications and treatments, as well as signs and symptoms, that makes you a better HCC coder. So it's very exciting. If you like diagnosis coding, then this is absolutely the way for you to go. It's really good for clinicians because they're already in that world, aren't they? You know. So again, this is a fun area to be in.
By the way, guys, a couple of you are talking about, you know, wanting presentations for your chapters. CCO offers free remote presentations. So very similar to what you're experiencing with this, Alicia and I volunteer our time to go ahead and present to chapters all over the country, but remotely, so we don't have to fly and do all of that. So we've had four or five chapters take advantage of that in January and February were scheduled. Now I've got one for March and one for April. So our dance card is filling up fast, but Alicia can present on what is HCC coding and go into depth for that. I've been doing the CPT update, the modifiers presentation, my E&M presentation. So if you're interested in that, reach out to us. You can email me, Laureen@codingcertification.org. Or have your chapter officer reach out to me, and we can, you know, set it up. As long as it fits in our schedule, it's you know, pretty good. And the reason we do it is because we want to get, you know, the CCO name out there. But we don't charge, and we don't advertise the whole time that, you know, we're talking. It's just this is who we are. If you're interested, you know, come to our site. So.
And it's not easy, as Laureen and I know, and many of you know, to find a speaker for your chapter events. And this way. Right. Again, we can, if it fits into our schedule, you know, and we're somewhat flexible, so it's a great way to have a guest speaker.
Need more medical certification training? Go to www.codingcertification.org.